Hey everyone, Case1320 here to do another quick video review. Joined today by Jeff, aka Slinger.
Hey everybody, how you doing?
Gonna do one of our, we've been doing some dual reviews lately and they're working out really good and plus they're a lot of fun, so we are going to do one today for evaporclouds.com. This will be for their cherry limeade and their cinnamon blueberry crumble. So, I know Jeff, you vape both of these.
Yep, definitely vape both of them. The cherry limeade is loaded up in the Mastodon right now. CE2 at 4.4 volts, but I have vaped it every which way a Sunday.
Very, very cool. I am vaping the cherry limeade in the Proveri at, I think it's up to like 5.1 volts. I'm going to go take a quick hit. I tell you, this is one of those juices, when I first got it, I was like, wow, this is awesome. And it is, in all fairness, a very, very good juice. Would I make this an all-day vape for myself? Probably not, no. Not because of the flavor, but just because I think that the lime, after a while, might start, like, just bothering me a little bit. Again, that's a personal thing. There's absolutely nothing wrong with the juice at all. Actually quite good. Just all day probably wouldn't be for me.
Okay, well, with me, before I was hitting it in my fat tank, and it really brought out the lime real a lot. The cherry is awesome, by the way, in this flavor. If you guys are looking for a really good tasting cherry is probably one of the best cherries I've tasted in e-liquid vapes. The lime in the fat tank is overbearing. And we had talked about this before, Case, that I didn't think it could be my all-day vape either. But in the CE2, I am noticing a big tone down in the lime.
Very, very cool. Well, I might have to try that. And to say what you said about the cherry earlier, absolutely the best cherry flavor I've ever had in an e-juice, in a vape. Not medicinal tasting at all, not medicine cough drop tasting. It's just a really good, fresh cherry flavor. So definitely props on that, because cherry is one of those things, it's really hard to get right. Joe has got it right, and I will try it. I'm doing it in a corner right now. Maybe I will break a CE2 out and give it a try. And like I said, still a very solid juice. And if you like vape, you know, lime a lot right now, like Key Lime Pie or something like that, and love it and do it all day, then you will have absolutely no problem with it.
I want to bring up the point, too, that this is a 50-50 blend of vegetable glycerin and I can never say that.
Propylene glycol.
Got it.
Yes.
I got 30 mils of it, and I'm doing 12 milligram strength. Also, back to the fat tank, I wasn't getting a whole lot of throat hit from the fat tank, but I was getting way more flavor. Now with the CE2, I've got that perfect amount of what I call like a 5-6 throat hit and a lot less lime, so I've found the way I'm going to vape it from now on.
Very cool. And mine is actually the exact same milligram, the exact same ratio. Throat hit for me is right on par with all Joe's juices at 12 milligram. Really no different, no more, no less. Actually just about perfect for me.
Right, and I usually don't notice a big difference when I go throat hit-wise. I usually just jack up the voltage if it's not enough throat hit on the fat tank or the slim tank or what have you. Some people call them smart tanks now, the thinner ones, but Joe's got them over there. He calls them slim tanks. The fat tank, I the flavor comes out in these like crazy with the Smoke Tech dual coils, but that's not what I'm vaping right now. I'm vaping an old-fashioned CE2, and that's the way I like this. So I do suggest, if you get it, try it in a couple different combinations. My favorite's a CE2, and I'd give it throat hit a 5 or a 6 on the CE2.
Yeah, I'd be about the same way on the throat hit. For flavor for this one, I'm going to give it a solid 7. Again, no fault of Joe's, because the flavor is really good. It's just it's not something I would personally vape all day. But if cherry limeade is your thing, you would definitely like it, because the flavor is there, and it's, you know, a really good cherry flavor. Now,
you know it.
Okay.
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
I'm going to say that I would give it a 7.2, and that's really weird because we argue about how much we like the same stuff. I agree it's a 7.
Yeah. Now, the second juice that we're going to be doing today, which is the Cinnamon Blueberry Crumble. I also have this in a 30-mo bottle. Same percentages, 50-50 and 12 milligrams. I'm not sure what Jeff's is, but...
First, before we start with that, can we go back to, like, vapor production?
We can, yes.
The vapor production, awesome on either the Fat Tank or the CE2 on the Cherry Limeade. And, you know, that's milligrams of strength. That's up to you. I don't think it's going to affect the taste that much, but no. I'm at 12 now, so that's where I like it.
Very cool.
So... And price-wise, Joe's always right on track with his prices, so that's for me, it's a win-win situation with the Cherry Limeade. I wouldn't call it an all-day vape. In the CE2, it's definitely more of an all-day vape. Fat Tank, definitely not. Maybe I could vape it for an hour, and then I'd say, hold on.
Okay.
So, all right, moving right along. You go ahead.
All right. Just the Cinnamon Blueberry Crumble we'll do next. Jeff has actually been vaping this for a few days now. I just got mine yesterday. In Joe's E-Vapor Clouds Facebook page, I called him an evil man last night because I don't know what he's doing. I like to DIY the majority of my juice. And I don't know, dude. It's just Joe's, like, capturing me with some of these flavors. First, it was the Papa Smurf, one of my I can't live without juices. And now it's this goddamn blueberry cinnamon crumble. I don't know what he does. I'm starting to hate him for it, dude.
All right. Blueberry cinnamon crumble, I love, and I'll tell you why. He's got the cinnamon in there. He's got the crumble in there, but neither of them are overtaking the blueberry.
Mm-mm.
Which most people, when they do cinnamons, you know, it just destroys a lot of everything else that's in there. I love the blueberry crumble taste-wise. In a fat tank, in a CE2, in a slim tank, I will vape blueberry crumble with you.
Yeah, dude, in any of the things you said, in an atomizer, like vape through a straw somehow off your desk, whatever. not that I recommend that, so don't do that at home, kids. But this shit is complete win. It's just there is not enough awesome words to describe this juice.
And actually, I've been vaping this longer than a couple days because it was actually released before it was on the website to me so I could check it out.
Right.
And Joe said if I thought it was a win, he might bring it out. I said, Joe, you got to release it. It's awesome.
It's completely amazing. I've been vaping it like the whole second half of this because I can't stop vaping. I can't. Like I said, Papa Smurf, my tied for first. Apple Pancake, again, we did this last review, and Papa Smurf are my two favorite juices. This is now tied with those other two.
See, with the Apple Pancake, it's been so long since I had it, I'm starting to forget what it tastes like. I need to get some of that again. To put it one-on-one against the blueberry cinnamon crumble, because right now, blueberry cinnamon crumble... It holds the heavyweight championship title for great vapes.
They're in my book. Like I said, they're all tied in my book. Those three are just amazing e-liquids that, to be honest with you, would have a hard time living without. Flavor, the way I've been ranting about it, I'm going to give that a 10 right off the bat.
Wow.
Yeah.
So someone's feeling generous today. I give it a 9.5 because I've never experienced breaking... the scale yet. This is an awesome vape. It's an all-day vape. I'm good with it. It's a 50-50 blend. I'm at 12 milligrams. The vapor production is right up there. Excuse me. With 50-50 blends, everybody knows that creates a really good vapor combination. Right now on the Proveri, I'm going to check my voltage. Well, you got to remember, this is 4.1 volts, but it's a dual coil in a slim tank. And the vapor production is, of course, awesome when you've got, you know, 4.1 volts.
Right.
With a dual coil. But it does provide good vapor no matter what unit you put it in.
Yeah. Vapor production for me, like I said, as all Joe's juices, it's perfect, spot on. I mean, I'm on my coffee mod at, well, you're not going to be able to see it, but trust me, it's 4.7 volts, and on a 3-ohm Bogue Cardo, it don't got no better than this.
Agreed. Okay, so price factor, Joe's got he does those crazy daily deals,
yes,
and stuff, so watch out for those people. I know that the blueberry cinnamon crumble was on sale. I don't know if it is now.
You know, I think it still might be the flavor of the week for a couple days.
Okay, so people run out and grab that one because it's a steal.
It is.
If you haven't checked out evaporclouds.com, please do. Also Facebook it. And, yeah, blueberry cinnamon crumble, win-win.
Very cool. And I don't know why, but your cam just froze for a second.
Mm.
But we're done the review anyway, I think, right?
I think that about wraps it up, folks.
All right. So, it's a frozen Jeff picture there, but trust me, it really is Jeff. I swear. And there it goes. It just came back now. Oh, well. Technical difficulties. What are you going to do? You do this shit live, and, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, check them both out. Again, cherry limeade, awesome vape. The blueberry cinnamon crumble, absolutely amazing in my opinion. I'm going to give that juice all around perfect 10s. I don't care. I don't, yeah, screw it.
Perfect. It's 10. A 9.5 on the AKA scale. Mm-hmm. I've got a solid 7 for the cherry limeade. And, yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, and the limeade, I would go 7 with that also. But the winner out of these two definitely was the cinnamon blueberry crumble for me.
And let's face it, folks, that e-juice has come a long way in taste and value. We're not dealing with what we dealt with a year ago.
No. And one thing to also remember is taste is totally subjective. So,
yeah, it is.
You know, I like to say that in all my reviews because it is absolutely true. Just because me and Jeff like something or dislike something doesn't mean you're going to be the same way. So,
and I do try to buy juices that I do like to do reviews that I think I'm going to like. Mm-hmm. Who wants to buy juices that they don't like?
Well, we have all done it in the past, you know.
Right, right. And, you know, I've kind of gotten to know my taste sensories for vaping, and I try to aim for that. So.
All right, that's going to wrap it up, guys. Thanks for watching. EVaporClouds.com. Go check it out. I'll see you later.